So we know that culture drives outcomes generally. For example, there's a lot of data that that a safety culture, which is the sense of safety of those of us doing the healthcare, actually is correlated with better patient care, safer patient care. And yet, culture is never written down. You know, if you think about it, there's no manual of culture anywhere you've ever worked or I've ever worked. But it's such a powerful driver of outcomes. One definition I really like is from a colleague of mine, Tony Sukman, who's an internist, is it's patterns of relating that persist and change through ongoing interaction. So we got to look at the, we've got to look at the patterns of relating and see, are those patterns of relating supporting the kind of culture that gets us the outcomes that we want, or are they undermining the kind of culture that we want? A particularly important aspect of culture is psychological safety in healthcare. So psychological safety is this concept that we as healthcare providers on a team will not be humiliated if we speak up, if we ask a question, if we voice a concern, that we and all of our fellow team members will be treated with respect. The reason psychological safety matters is broadly twofold. One is it has an intense effect on how it feels to come to work. I think you know if you've been working in an environment and it's very challenging, I mean, you've got lots of work to do, which is, you know, what it's like to practice medicine. If you know that you're supported by your team, your colleagues, even the organization, that work becomes joyful and sustainable, even when it's challenging. The converse is when there are behaviors that undermine psychological safety, it really has an ill effect on our workplace engagement and our well-being. In addition to psychological safety effect on us and our well-being, it has a known effect on patient care. For all of the reasons that I think have been elucidated in the studies about setting up a safety culture, that we're not going to use shame and blame. We're not going to humiliate people. We're going to react to harm events, for example, in a way that actually fosters learning and growth so that these things don't happen again, so that we can work to improve both on a personal level and on a systems level. So psychological safety is foundational. The challenge with psychological safety is you can't just tell people to do it. I think it's when we're stressed and tired, it's easy to fall into kinds of patterns of behaviors that might undermine psychological safety.